autumn wind slides across the vast steppe lands of Mongolia as a fleeting fall transitions into yet another frigid winter. Devoid of freeways, fences, and rest stops, remote valleys carved into a countryside sculpted by rivers create a backdrop reminiscent of the American West. Windblown prayer flags hang from a shrine towering above, while a man on horseback beckons a ferry across river with his horse. And the day ends seated in a local's home, dining on fresh sheeptail and drinking fermented mare's milk, telling stories about the day on the river, chasing the world's largest salmonid, the taimen. Roughly the size of Alaska, Mongolia is the least densely populated country on the planet. Outside of the capital, Ulaanbaatar, major cities don't exist. Typical towns look something like this: Main Street, grocery store, butcher shop,
and fishing guides excited to find cold beer after a long day on the water.
The quickest transportation is efficient. Just don't crush a month's worth of eggs while taking your seat or a herd upon landing. But it's not quite as authentic as the 10-hour, 150-mile car rides, where the only other traffic are nomads mounted on horseback. Wish you were born 100 years earlier? Quit daydreaming and experience the real last frontier.
I've been guiding 9 years. Every day, every single day, I'm still learning how to guide for the taimen fish. We are using the dry flies. The big fish, when they take in that dry fly, it's just unbelievable.
The thing that I really love about it is the appreciation that you get out of catching a taimen. It's not easy at all. It's a numbers game, so you're looking at probably 25 to 40 fish per square kilometer. I'll be doing a lot of casting. You're covering a lot of water every day, and what I've always told my clients is that moment that you think it's not gonna happen, you need to keep pushing through, because it can just be that one stretch of water and you can get that fish of a lifetime.
I'm Baira, people calling around here Big Fish Baira. I'm guiding mostly for taimen. Taimen is the biggest salmonid. Taimen is very aggressive. They're eating small fish, nice burrow, small ducklings. What we call it's river wall. On the surface, dry fly fishing, taimen, it's more fun.
It's the most epic place on the planet. When you've got such an ultimate predator in the river and you fish for something that just wants to kill stuff, I mean, with a combination of beautiful surroundings and awesome people, I mean, that's as good as it gets.
With access that's limited at best, many of Mongolia's taimen rivers flow through the country's most isolated areas. And yet, these waterways are just as fragile as they are pristine. Fortunately, thriving grassroots fly fishing communities and conservation groups are working hand in hand with local communities, guides, and outfitters to ensure these rivers will be protected for generations to come.
Many, many young and also many people come into fly fishing. Everybody now says now we need the catch and release and protect taimen.
Being from South Africa or Africa, you see a lot of fisheries that are not managed very well, and it's so amazing to come to a fishery where you feel like people are trying to look after the fish and really putting lots of effort. The cool thing is when we spend time on the river, it becomes your home, and you kind of want to protect your home. And when you're in Mongolia, you feel the passion and you feel how they want to protect their fisheries, which is just amazing to me. It's really nice to see that.